All right, so come on over, let's take a look. All right, how do we find the percent of a number? Well, I've been working with this with my students, and percent of a number is, I always tell them one formula. It's only because it's easier. You take whatever your percent is. Let's say you know 20%. You put that number over 100. And then you're going to equal that to the part over the whole. And in Laura's situation, and I'm going to continue that, the whole is the $120 that she has saved. The part is how much she's going to spend on each of these people. All right, so let's take a look here. Brittany is explaining to a friend how she wants to spend an equal amount of her money and on her family and best friend. She has $120 to spend. What percent of the money will she spend on each person? Now, if you remember, Laura did the tape diagram, so she actually figured it out. So if I take the 120 again, and I divide it by the five people that she's going to go with, so you have two, and then, so you have your $24 on each person. So we want to know what percent of the money that is. So if you do, I'm going to just put a P for percent over 100. And then you put your part over your whole. Okay? And let me give myself a little bit more space. I have 120. P equals, and then I'm just going to quickly do 24 times 100. Remember, it's the 1 times 24 and then the two zeros. So now we're going to quickly take and divide by the 120. This is the algebra that Laura was talking about. So we divide by the 120. So how many 120s are in 240? There's two, and then we have this zero. So if she were to spend the same amount on everybody, everybody gets 20%. So let's take a look. What if she decides that she wants to spend 30% of her money on each of her parents instead of everybody getting the same amount? So how much will she spend on her parents? Well, this is the same formula. Remember, you have your percent over 100 is equal to your part over your whole. So my percent is 30%. And I don't really need the percent sign. Let's get rid of that and not mess up my students. Is equal to, we're trying to find out the part, how much she will spend on her parents and how much she'll have left. Well, she has 120 total. And this is the part I'll use. Let's not use P again since I use P for percent. Don't want to mess everyone up. We'll use N. What's the money? All right. So now you're going to cross multiply. So you do 120 times 30, 0, 0, 6, 3. So you got 3,600 is equal to 100N. Divide by your 100. Divide by your 100. Your N is 36. And it's dollars, and what was the last? How much will she spend on her parents? So she's spending 30%. Does it say on each of her parents? Yes, so you've got $36 on mom and $36 on dad. So she is spending $72 on mom and dad. All right. And how much do we have left? Well, just like Laura was showing you, you take the 120 of her budget and you take away the 72. And I'm going to extend just a little bit more. Again, we're going to borrow. 10 minus 2 is 8. And 11 minus 7 is 4. So she has $48 left to spend on her brother, her sister, and her friend, okay? So if we can, if that's all of that I have up here is we have $48. We could decide, she has three people, we could decide and divide that 48 by three to see how much each of the brother, sister, and friend are gonna get. So again, 3 into 4 goes once. And 3 goes into 18, 6 times. And that gives us a zero at the bottom. So she could spend $16 on her sister, $16 on her brother, $16 on her friend, and then spend $36 on mom and $36 on dad. Thank you very much.